So now that the FDA is no longer making NAC, a nutritional supplement, available because they are deeming it a prescriptive drug, are you wondering what you're going to be able to do now about getting NAC and having that be prescribed, or what the fallout effect of all of this is? And ultimately, how do you get yourself feeling better because that NAC was helping? Or just what now? I'll tell you, as a provider, it's a really scary thing, because as an alternative healthcare provider, because these things should be available to everyone and it shouldn't be a prescription. And I understand prescriptions in terms of they address that they can treat. Prescriptions have the sole purpose, in the way that the law reads, that they're the only thing that is allowed to treat. And I think that's fine. I'm fine with that, because ultimately there needs to be regulation, there needs to be studies, there needs to be the ability to control and get better outcomes every time. There does. But when you start to now expand your borders into nutritional, and on the one hand you've already been saying that supplements and just even lifestyle change is to be poo-pooed, and what's to be put at the forefront is what we tell you to do for health, and that is being able to treat you directly and making things mandated. It's a really slippery slope in a lot of different ways. So as far as NAC goes, the initial supplement companies typically promote it for helping to do a lot of healthful detoxification things. And more so than detoxification, it gets into glutathione production. And if you think about glutathione production, glutathione is important for so many regulations in terms of, it's an antioxidant, we all know, but it's more complicated than that. It also helps to coordinate and signal how your body is signaling all over, how the entire cells, the immune system, the GI system, the neurological system, the endocrine system, how all of these things play a role. And communication is key in this instance for glutathione production. And glutathione also helps with detoxification. And it also helps with just dealing with stress and cortisol. And it helps in a lot of things. It helps so much. And ultimately, NAC is a prerequisite to making glutathione. However, a lot of people do poorly with NAC, and that's because there are some challenges with getting to make glutathione out of just getting more NAC. Sometimes cysteine and cysteine, and the way that gets into combined with glutamate and also glycine, has their own challenges. There's other rate limiting steps in that whole process. So getting more cysteine or N-acetylcysteine may make that person more agitated and inflamed, because cysteine, if it's not getting through to be able to support glutathione production because of a host of things we just mentioned, one being in this video we'll talk about is glycine, and that's a really major supporting nutrient. However, when cysteine can't make it to glutathione, it's going to combine with the reasons why the body's been signaled to make glutathione, which is that oxidative stress you got going on in your body, the overwhelm, the chemical exposures, the inflammation, just your psychological stress, has a lot to do with all those things going on. And ultimately, if you're not able to get there, and that combines with those things, it creates more inflammation. More precisely, that cysteine combines with hydroxyl radicals, and it produces produces hydroxyl radicals. So it combines with hydrogen peroxide because glutathione is depleted, or there's even problems with how glutathione is signaled, it's not just NAC. So it goes so much deeper than that. But ultimately, thing we were talking about, now this is where it's hard because we're crossing the road and we're talking at the same time. Do not try this at home. So, okay, so as far as the three amino acids, glutamic acid, which is derived from glutamate, you also have glycine, and then you also have so what we're talking about is cysteine. Now that's pretty impressive, telling you about the three amino acids and crossing the road at the same time and the light changing and having to process all those things going on. That's pretty impressive. Well, at least for me it is. So anyways, as far as we continuing the conversation, is these three amino acids, glutamic acid, cysteine, and glycine, they have to help deal with all the things that glutathione is signaled to do. And that's inflammation in the body, that's having to detox, that's having to coordinate systems between endocrine and GI and brain, and it has to communicate and make that. And that's part of the key cellular process. And NAC may not get there anyways. And so that's another layer of how frustrating something like this is, to be able to treat patients and have the exclusive monopoly on it for financial purposes is one frustrating thing. But the other frustrating thing is it's wrong because there's so many things wrong with just taking NAC. And I think we should bother to learn about that so that you can realize that it's never going to be completely about a drug that you can treat, because there's so many factors that you need to do: lifestyle, mindset, movement, nutrition, family situations, social stuff. All those things need to be considered too, when you are, more importantly than when you are not able to get NAC anymore. And that's the frustrating part as well. And because that should be taught in curriculums, and it should be demanded by third parties, and it should be standard of cares for the new healthcare model. And that's where the revolution always has to take place, with the frustrated citizens. And that's always been a lesson through time. If with revolts and revolutions, your actions, collective actions, make more of a impact than complaining about it or not doing anything about it, and ultimately being your best advocate despite of that. But that's the frustrating thing. So what I would say to you is, with the NAC, is understand that if it makes you better, that's great. That it is supporting your glutathione production. And with that, there's a lot of key physiological functions that improve. But ultimately, with my experience, the people that we help that are exhausted and burnt out have been dealing with that for a long time, and it's more complex than that. And NAC will not be as effective for long terms if those things don't get addressed at the same time. So that's what I wanted to produce this video about, is if you're curious about the NAC, why is it being put as a drug and only for pharmaceutical purposes, and you're concerned that it's because I do well with it and I want it, or you're a provider and you're thinking, well, now what am I supposed to do about helping my clientele get NAC? I mean, you can't just go and say, okay, I'm going to take glycine and I am going to even take glutamine or glutamate, because that's one of the main challenges that got us here on this video in the first place, with having to take NAC and being concerned that they're taking it off, is that your glutamate levels are jammed, and those aren't ultimately converting into glutathione either. And that's where your glutamate isn't being useful, except it's causing you more anxiety and overwhelm, and it's creating more challenges. And one of the really helpful ways that, because I have challenges with glutamate, is, which is a blessing. I mean, listen, having challenges with glutamate is a blessing because it makes you motivated, it makes you intelligent, it makes you driven. However, too much of it makes you anxious and even paranoid. And when your glutamate levels are really high like that, taking the folate test or the niacin challenge can be really helpful. Now, you need to talk to providers about that to get more insight because there's so many variables. But if those glutamate levels are super high like that, then taking NAC, I'm guessing, if it did work for you, is going to be short term, or it's going to stop working as effectively, or it's going to make you worse. And that's another good part of this video, is if NAC made you worse, this is why. And that will be another video. This is more about just NAC and why you have the concerned about it not being available and not being able to get it. What are you going to do now? And for the providers that need to understand that we need to look at how to lower glutamate, how to support glutathione production because of all of that, and if that means more recycling or more utilization or more signaling or more just production of the actual nutrient and everything that it needs to do that. That behooves us as a profession to learn that and to understand it, and most importantly, apply that to your patients, to the people, your coaching clients, to the people that you help, because we're struggling with putting these puzzle pieces together. And to take NAC away from people that it was ultimately helping, because now it's being classified as a drug, is alarming for a lot of reasons. And I wanted to make it more educational for you for this video so that you can get some really good information about it. So in the meantime, stay tuned for my next video, which is going to be on NAC and why it may not be helpful for people if you felt worse with it. I'll make a video on that. Let me know if you have any questions.